Hello. It sounds like you're setting the stage for a fascinating exploration of the challenges Australian farmers face with invasive fox populations. These cunning predators indeed pose significant risks to livestock and native wildlife, impacting the agricultural landscape in various ways. Farmers often have to employ a range of strategies to manage fox populations, from fencing and guard animals to traps and community-wide control programs. To balance between maintaining biodiversity and protecting agricultural interests is a complex issue. If you'd like to delve deeper into specific methods or stories from farmers, feel free to share. The image you're painting is vivid and unsettling. Foxes, with their agile bodies and keen hunting skills, can indeed wreak havoc on farms, particularly those close to their natural habitats. The calm of the early morning can quickly turn to chaos as these predators exploit any vulnerabilities. Farmers often face the heartbreaking aftermath of such attacks, finding their livestock injured or worse. The impact on both the animals and the farmers' livelihoods can be devastating. Many have turned to various protective measures, like reinforced coops or guard animals, but the challenge remains significant, especially in rural areas where fox populations thrive. The situation you've described is alarming and highlights the increasing adaptability of foxes to urban environments. Their ability to venture into residential areas not only threatens pets and livestock, but also raises concerns about safety for residents. When foxes begin to see neighborhoods as their territory, it complicates wildlife management and community safety. Reports of foxes entering homes or attacking pets can create panic among residents, leading to calls for more effective control measures. Communities might respond with a mix of education on how to secure trash and pet food, along with local efforts to manage the fox population. It's a complex issue that blends wildlife behavior, agricultural impacts, and community dynamics. That sounds like a harrowing experience for the woman involved. Encounters like these can leave lasting scars both physically and emotionally. The fear of future attacks can deeply affect how people feel in their own neighborhoods or on their farms, impacting their daily lives. Using traps to control fox populations is indeed a significant strategy for many Australian farmers and communities. While traps can help manage the numbers, they must be used carefully to ensure humane practices and minimize unintended harm to other wildlife. Public awareness and community involvement are also crucial in managing these challenges. Education on securing properties, along with responsible trapping practices, can help mitigate the risks while balancing the ecosystem. If you want to explore more about community responses or the effectiveness of various control measures, your description highlights a practical approach that many farmers take to manage fox populations. Using traps can indeed be an effective way to control invasive species while allowing farmers to maintain the health of their livestock and crops. The careful selection of trap locations based on fox activity is crucial for success. Farmers often observe patterns in fox behavior, such as common pathways or feeding spots, to determine the best places to set traps. This strategic thinking helps increase the likelihood of capturing these elusive animals. Regularly checking traps is also important, not just for effectiveness, but to ensure humane treatment of any captured foxes. In addition to traps, some farmers might use bait that's specifically designed to attract foxes while minimizing risks to other wildlife. Careful management and consideration of ecological balance. While trapping has proven effective, it's essential to approach fox control with a holistic strategy. This includes understanding the role foxes play in the ecosystem and ensuring that control measures do not inadvertently harm other wildlife. Additionally, ongoing monitoring and assessment are vital to gauge the long-term effectiveness of trapping efforts. Farmers often need to adapt their strategies based on results and the potential for fox populations to rebound. Education and community involvement are also crucial components. Engaging local communities in awareness campaigns can promote responsible practices and support for trapping initiatives. By fostering cooperation among farmers, landowners, and wildlife experts, Australia can work towards sustainable solutions for managing invasive species like foxes while protecting agricultural interests. Unchecked, their populations can lead to significant disruption. In agricultural regions, particularly in New South Wales and Victoria, Foxes can cause serious damage to crops and livestock, making hunting a practical approach for many farmers. Hunting, while often seen as a recreational activity, serves a dual purpose. It helps reduce fox numbers and can foster a sense of community among farmers. However, it's essential that hunting practices are regulated to ensure they are conducted safely and ethically, respecting wildlife conservation principles. Farmers need to strike a balance, acknowledging that while foxes are a natural part of the ecosystem, their numbers must be managed to protect agricultural interests and biodiversity. Ongoing education about sustainable practices and the importance of integrated pest management can help ensure that both the environment and farming livelihoods are preserved. Can have far-reaching consequences when fox populations swell unchecked. They not only threaten livestock but can also disrupt local ecosystems. Reduced livestock numbers can lead to a decline in food availability for larger predators, which may then struggle to find adequate sustenance, further impacting the food web. Moreover, an overabundance of foxes can lead to increased predation on native wildlife, some of which may already be vulnerable or endangered. This pressure can exacerbate the decline of these species, affecting biodiversity and altering the natural balance of the ecosystem. Wildlife management agencies face significant challenges in addressing these issues. Implementing effective control measures requires careful planning and collaboration with farmers, conservationists, and the community. It's crucial to adopt integrated approaches that combine trapping, hunting, and public education to manage fox populations while minimizing adverse effects on other wildlife. Is a key reason why foxes can thrive in agricultural areas, making them particularly challenging for farmers. Their opportunistic feeding habits allow them to adapt quickly, leading to significant damage to both crops and livestock. Hunting provides farmers with a more active approach to managing these populations. By tracking foxes and locating their dens, they can target their efforts more effectively. This method not only allows for quicker action compared to waiting for traps to work, but also enables farmers to gain a better understanding of fox behavior and movement patterns. Hunting provides farmers with a more active approach to managing these populations. By tracking foxes and locating their dens, they can target their efforts more effectively. This method not only allows for quicker action compared to waiting for traps to work, but also enables farmers to gain a better understanding of fox behavior and movement patterns. Often use various techniques to increase their chances of success. Imitating fox cries is a well-known strategy, as it can effectively attract curious foxes, making them more vulnerable to hunters. The nighttime environment adds an element of excitement and challenge, as visibility is limited and foxes may feel less cautious under the cover of darkness. As hunters approach the farm's boundaries, they need to be quiet and patient, listening for any signs of movement. Their hunting equipment, typically including specialized firearms or spotlights, allows them to engage effectively while minimizing disturbance to the surrounding wildlife. During sheep breeding season, the urgency to protect livestock is heightened, prompting farmers to take proactive measures like these. The balance between hunting and maintaining healthy ecosystems remains critical, so hunters must also consider safety and ethical practices during their outings. The tension builds as hunters navigate the dark, often unpredictable terrain. Their physical fitness is crucial, as they must remain agile and alert, able to carry their equipment while moving stealthily. The cover of night does provide some advantages, like reduced visibility for the foxes, but it also presents challenges such as navigating uneven ground and staying aware of their surroundings. Stalking requires patience and strategy. Hunters often take their time, waiting for the right moment to strike while remaining as quiet as possible. The thrill of the hunt intensifies as they anticipate potential encounters with foxes, making every nose and movement feel significant. When their efforts pay off, and they successfully take down multiple foxes in one night, it can bring a sense of relief and accomplishment. This proactive approach helps reduce the immediate threat to their livestock and crops, but it also reinforces the need for ongoing management of fox populations. And root through the ground, causing extensive damage to crops, soil, and natural vegetation. their aggressive foraging behavior not only disrupts agricultural activities, but also outcompetes native wildlife for resources, leading to a decline in local biodiversity. Feral hogs are incredibly adaptable and reproduce rapidly, which contributes to their escalating populations. The sheer number of these animals poses significant challenges for farmers, who often resort to various control methods, including hunting, trapping, and sometimes even aerial gunning. The economic impact is staggering, with billions of dollars lost each year due to crop destruction, damage to infrastructure, and increased management costs. Farmers are constantly on the lookout for effective strategies to mitigate these losses, which has led to a combination of community efforts and state sponsor initiatives to address the feral hog problem. Balance to keep their populations in check. The absence of significant predators allows feral hog numbers to grow unchecked, exacerbating the challenges faced by farmers. The damage caused by these animals is not just physical. It also affects the mental and emotional well-being of farmers, who must constantly contend with the threat to their livelihoods. The financial implications can be devastating, as even a single night of destruction can result in losses that take a season to recover from. Farmers have implemented various prevention methods, such as stronger fencing, electronic deterrence, and baiting strategies, but the adaptability and intelligence of feral hogs often render these measures insufficient. Hunting remains a popular control method, with many communities organizing events to manage hog populations, but it's clear that a multifaceted approach is necessary. State agencies are increasingly involved in addressing this crisis, providing resources and support for farmers. Some have initiated programs to promote hunting and trapping, while others are researching biological control methods or fertility control in hopes of curbing population growth and water, making them even harder to control. This adaptability is one of the primary reasons feral hog populations have exploded in areas like Texas. Their high reproductive rate, combined with their resilience in various environmental conditions, means that even aggressive control measures can struggle to keep their numbers in check. With females capable of giving birth to multiple litters throughout the year, and each litter containing several piglets, the potential for rapid population growth is staggering. In prime habitats, such as agricultural land, these numbers can increase significantly, compounding the damage they inflict on crops and the surrounding ecosystem. Farmers often find themselves in a continuous cycle of damage and repair, as feral hogs can return to the same areas repeatedly, especially if those areas are rich in resources. This cycle requires farmers to stay vigilant and adaptable in their strategies. Integrated management approaches, combining trapping, hunting, and habitat modification, are essential for mitigating the impact of feral hogs. Education and community engagement also play crucial roles in creating effective management plans that involve the entire farming community. Ability to exploit available resources efficiently. This voracious appetite allows feral hogs to thrive in diverse environments, making them particularly damaging to agricultural areas. Their tendency to target crops can lead to severe economic losses for farmers, as they can decimate fields in a matter of hours. In addition to their impact on crops, feral hogs pose a threat to livestock as well. When forage becomes scarce, they may resort to predation on smaller animals, including sheep and even young deer, which can further disrupt local ecosystems and agricultural practices. Their rapid digestion and high consumption rates mean that feral hogs can cover large distances in search of food, often leading them into new areas where they can establish populations and cause additional damage. This adaptability not only complicates management efforts, but also underscores the importance of coordinated control strategies across regions. To combat the threat posed by feral hogs, farmers and wildlife agencies are exploring a range of solutions, from improved fencing and land management practices to community-based hunting initiatives. Educating the public about the ecological impact of feral hogs and fostering collaborative efforts can be key in addressing this persistent problem. Arrow hogs into the traps. The use of bait is crucial, as it helps lure the pigs into the enclosure, where they can be captured without causing harm to other wildlife. beast traps are often designed to be sturdy enough to withstand the strength of the hogs, preventing them from breaking free once inside. While fencing provides an important first line of defense, it can be costly and may not be practical for larger farms. Combining fencing with trapping creates a more comprehensive management strategy, allowing farmers to actively reduce feral hog populations while protecting their crops and livestock. Farmers also need to consider the layout of their land when placing traps. Identifying areas where hogs frequently travel or feed can increase the likelihood of successful captures. Regular monitoring and maintenance of both traps and fences are essential to ensure ongoing effectiveness. In addition to these physical barriers and traps, some farmers are turning to community initiatives and hunting programs to help manage feral hog populations more broadly. Collaboration among neighbors can amplify efforts and share the financial and labor burdens associated with control measures. To safeguard their crops, the nighttime activities of feral hogs make it essential for farmers to adapt their strategies. As you mentioned, during the night, the visibility for wild boars decreases, giving farmers a slight advantage for monitoring and managing their presence. Using traps effectively allows farmers to capture multiple pigs at once, which is crucial when dealing with larger herds. The ability to take down several feral hogs simultaneously can significantly reduce the threat to crops like rice and soybeans, especially during peak growing seasons when these plants are particularly vulnerable. After capturing the hogs, farmers often face decisions about how to dispose of them. Some may choose to leave them to decompose naturally, while others might transport them for processing. This decision can depend on local regulations, as well as the resources available to farmers. The financial burden of managing feral hog populations, estimated at around $3 million annually, underscores the serious economic implications for agriculture in Texas.